So hello class, good morning. Now we're on our second part or on our second video discussion and our subject. And our previous video, we talked about the nature of cause, the types of cause. And now, continue ko to. No, kaya I think wala ko ni siya na-explain sa inyo sa previous video. So, the graph of total cost, the variable cost, and fixed cost. So, you have here the graph. Now, as you can see on the screen, first is the fixed cost. So, example, if we have a fixed cost of 300, so our graph is parallel to our horizontal line, no? At derive is 300 na di ang ano level, no? Cost, no? It's in euros pa. So still the same is peso. Our horizontal line is quantity, no? Number of quantity, and our vertical line is the cost. So we have here fixed cost, no? It's horizontal. Why? As I have said, fixed cost does not change regardless of our quantity. Now, at any levels of quantity, our fixed cost is still the same. So that is why our line is parallel to our horizontal line, which is our quantity. Pero dari siya nag-start sa 300 since, amo na ganing class nga, our fixed cost is fixed at 300, for example. And we're done with fixed cost. So let's go to the graph of variable cost. So variable cost increases as quantity increases. So it is directly proportional to quantity. So we have here, it starts with zero since if we have no production, so we have zero variable cost. That's why if we have zero quantity, we have zero cost for variable cost. So as our quantity increases, our variable cost increases. Okay, so klaro na atong graph sa variable cost and fixed cost. Then let's go to the graph of total cost. Since total cost is variable cost plus fixed cost, so our total cost will start here. No, from the point nga ang fixed cost started sa zero quantity, no? Kay since even though you don't produce, you still incur fixed cost. No? So, for zero quantity, your total cost would be equal to your fixed cost. So, you have no variable cost since you have no quantity produced. And as your quantity increases, your total cost increases. So, it is parallel to the graph of variable cost. But the starting point of total cost starts from the fixed cost here. Okay, so this is your graph. Graph of total cost. You have your fixed cost, you have your total cost, and you have your variable cost. Okay, so understood na tada. So we have here the summary. The summary, amo na siyang gin-explain ko kagapon sa graph atong ara sa Excel file, no? We don't have to read that. And we have here the short-run cost function and the long-run cost function. So from our prelim, we have a short-run the short run production function and short long run production function. So same as the short run cost function, the cost, but first let's talk all about the cost function. The cost function is a functional relationship between cost and output. Taton prelim niya is the relationship between our production, no, and output. It explains that the cost of production varies with the level of output given other things remain the same. So this is our cost function. So andi ta lang da pagpadalman kay base ano naman kamo karon. Anyway, I'll let you bawi man class sa midterm. Don't worry. Now where see this is ang aton nga formula is C is the cost of production and X is the level of output. No? So, in our short-run cost function, one variable is fixed and others are one one variable, one cost variable is fixed and others are all variable. So, isa ang fixed and others are variable. Tama na siya class ang short run cost function. And sili naman niya sa long run cost function in which sa long run cost function niya, all variables are variable. No? So, you have here total fixed cost. Fixed cost refers to the cost of fixed input. It does not change with the level of output. Thus, it is fixed. So, fixed inputs include building, machinery, etc. Hence, the cost of such inputs, such as rent or cost of machinery, constitutes fixed cost. So, aton short-run cost function consists of fixed cost and variable cost. So, hence, the cost of such in also referred to as overhead cost, supplementary cost, or indirect cost. These costs remain the same irrespective of level of input. No, so amuni siya, no, horizontal axis, we get a straight line parallel to the horizontal axis as what I have explained kagina, no, this is a short run cost function, saya, no. And the total variable cost, cost incurred on variable factors of production is called total variable cost. This cost vary with the level of output or production, thus when production level is zero, total variable cost is also zero. No, so the TVC curve begins from the origin. So amo ni sa class, no? Variable cost. Dari siya nag-start. Okay, no production, no variable cost. Okay. So total cost, that would be total fixed cost plus total variable cost. So ang aton nga short run cost function, amo ni siya ang itsura sa iya graph, no? Do ka inverted S ang total cost and total variable cost. So the following can be noted about the total cost curve. The total cost curve is inverted S shape. This is because of the total variable cost curve. Since the total fixed cost curve is horizontal, the difference between the total cost and the total variable cost is the same at each level of outputs and equals the total fixed cost. No, so this explains as follows: total cost less total variable cost. So since our no, sulit-uli man lang class, total cost is equal to your fixed cost plus variable cost. So if your total cost less total variable cost, so that would mean that that would equal to your total fixed cost. Okay, so okay naman. Total, explain ko naman na sa babaw. Okay, so the law that explains the shape of total variable cost and subsequently total cost is called the law of variable proportion. So same man to sa production. Anyway, class, di ka man magpadalong, pagpadalman, siniha kay, I'll make this simpler na to you this midterm kay para makabawi na kamo kay doon na tamaan, hindi ka mag-be sa prelim. Anyway, so long run cost function, all your variables are variable. All your costs are variable. So wala ta fixed cost sa long run cost function. So an example of a long run, a business with a one-year lease will have its long run defined as any period longer than 1 year since it's not bound by the lease agreement after that year. So in the long run, the amount of labor, size of the factory, and production processes can be altered if need to suit the needs of the business or lease issuer. So, amo na class kung long run, no? In a long period of time, you can change your amount of labor, no? Size of the factory, pwede kadaya ka change, no? It's no longer fixed na. So, all variables are variable. Okay. Economies of scale, saan nyo lang class, hindi nyo lang pag-ianon ha, hindi nyo lang gid pagpadalman ha, as what I have said pabawian, taka mo sa midterm. So, muna to, basta ang difference ng short run and long run, short run consists of fixed cost and variable cost, in long run, all costs are variable. Okay, so we have to go to learning curves. A learning curve is a graphical representation of the relationship between how proficient someone is a task and the amount of experience they have. So proficiency measured on vertical axis usually increases with increased experience. The horizontal axis. That is to say, the more someone perform a task, the better they get it. So learning curve. So we have here the learning curve formula, y is equal to axb, wherein y is the average time over the measured duration. So this is your time to complete the task. A represents the time to complete the task the first time. X represents the total amount of attempts, and B represents the slope of the function. So ang aton nga learning curve nga graph would be, diba y is average time, no, over a measured duration. So dali taas pa ang y, amunin mo number of attempts. So first attempt mo, syempre maluig-lawig mo ma-consume, no, kay since you are still learning pa, no. So for the first attempt mo, lawig-lawig pa imo nga ginagamit nga time. Second attempt mo, medyo dasig-dasig ka na, no. Third attempt, fourth attempt, and so on. At hasta nga kung damo na imo na attempts, no, since damo ka na, ano ni, as you repeat your attempts, no, as you have an increased attempts, you are learning along the way. So, the more you have the attempt, the more nga nag-learn ka. No? Ano na, schoology. Diba? Amo na sa class na itong quiz sa third attempt nyo, tagas na score nyo, first attempt nyo, lawig pa time nyo, nubo pa scores nyo, second attempt, medyo nubo-nubo time na gingamit nyo, then yung inyo score is nagdugang, then pagka third attempt, nagnubo na gid, then ang scores yung nagtaas naman, that would also be the same sa aton nga learning curve formula, no? The more you have the attempts, the lower the time you consume to complete that certain task. So that is a learning curve. Okay. Ari sa cost, volume, profit analysis and leverage, no, one of my favorite topics sa college. CVP analysis. Anyway, matake up nyo man siya on higher accounting subjects, but this is just introduction lang para maintindihan nyo man pagkadason sagad-sagad nagid ka mo sa CVP kag sa leverage. Anyway, this is also my topic sa senior high. And here, cost volume profit analysis is a method of cost accounting that looks at the impact that varying levels of cost and volume have on operating profit. So if you have changes on your cost and volume of production, it has an effect to your operating profit. So the CVP analysis, also known as the break-even analysis, looks to determine the break-even point for different sales volumes and cost structures, which can be useful for managers making short-term economic decisions. Mas naintindihan niyo siya if we have already taken up the computation side. Kaya explain ko niya why. So make several assumptions including the sales price, fixed cost, and variable cost. So good luck sa ato, no? Kay wala kita blackboard. Anyway, explain ko niya sa inyo. So focus di klasa, follow sa akon nga cursor and sa akong gina-highlightan. Let's highlight this. Dali lang. Where is the highlight? Okay, highlight. Yellow. Okay. Have you seen my highlight na class? And hold your calculators. Hold your calculators and papers and pencil. Dira sa inyo tupad. Now, we have here the break-even sales volume. We have the fixed cost over contribution margin. So, your fixed cost, usually this is expressed in pesos. Your contribution margin, usually this is expressed in percentage or in a per unit basis. Okay? So, for example, your CM is your selling price less your variable cost. Okay? Note nyo da. Contribution margin or your CM is equal to your selling price less your variable cost per unit. If it is in percentage, for example, kadto ta sa paano ta? Word. Okay, kadto ta sa word. Word, word, word. What? Nagkadto sa excess. Open ko word class ha. Ay, diri na lang ko sa WPS. I'll try. Okay, wait, language class. I'll try. Spreadsheet ah. Okay. Okay, para makita nyo ang... blank. Dugay mag-load. Okay, okay. Ito siya file. Dugay, giniblas ng WPS mo. As what, and as what I have, ano man, as what I have observed man sa inyo exam, damo nagamit sa inyo WPS. Anyway, we're here. So, I'll check if oh man, alright, WPS. Okay. Fixed cost over CM, that's break-even. Sales in volume. New share. Yeah, we're here. We're in the right place. So, tugina, so break-even sales in volume, that would be fixed cost divided by contribution margin. So, break-even sales in volume. So that means that would be in quantity equals fixed cost divided by your CM. Okay, kahina isang WPS. Follow lang kamo class ha. Follow lang kamo. I'm doing my best to explain sa inyo. Tama na siya. Merge and center. Okay. Fixed cost, break even sales in volume, that would be fixed cost over your CM. So, for example, your fixed cost is 100,000. Your selling price of your product would be 20, and your variable cost is 5. Therefore, your contribution margin is, so selling price less variable cost equals 20 less 5 is 15. Okay, follow kamo class. So this is selling price per unit ni class ha, unit. So manimo nga ang presyo sa imo nga per unit, no? So CM per unit, since we are looking for break even sales in volume. Okay, muna sa class. It gets, follow lang kamo. Then, if we will convert this into percentage, no, I'll explain na agin kwa tang percentage sini ha. So, if your selling price is 100%, so pila ang percentage ni variable cost kay selling price. So, that would be equals 5 divided by 20% to get the percentage. So it so variable cost is 25% of your selling price. How will I convert this? Okay, 25%. Therefore, your contribution margin percentage is 15 divided by 20 is 75%, or 100% less 25%. Okay, gets niya? So, we're done, no? Now, getting the contribution margin per unit and the CM percentage, which is 75%. So, kaunta si break-even sales in volume. So we will use the contribution margin per unit. No kay volume ang aton ginapangita. So we have here equals fixed cost of 100,000. Okay. Divided by your CM per unit of 15. Okay. Equals. So 100,000. Palogid ka mo class ha. Lantaw ka mo class. Divided by 15. So that would be 6,667 units. So that would be 6,667 units. Kaya wala man sang 0.66 nga unit, no? So, yung unit ya is bilog. So, wala man 0.66 nga unit. Ano na karoon ng itsura sina? So, 0.66 unit. Okay? Halo lang kamo class. Sunod gid ha? Then, muna, highlight ta para makita pagid. Okay? Double rule ta para makita nyo. So our break-even sales in volume is 6,667 units. Therefore, with this number of units, you are incurring zero profit. So 6,667 units. You are incurring. You are not incurring loss. Nor you are not incurring also profit. So, zero imo profit at this unit. Why? Break even. Dra ka break even. So, sa muna units, wala ka nagabenta. Zero imo profit. Okay? We'll check karon ha. So, if we'll check, if we will check, so 667,000, no? Example, if we will be selling this, we will having a zero profit. So, we'll check now. We have a revenue. No, that would be your selling price times the number of units. So equals 20 selling price times 6,667 units. So your revenue is 133,340. Your variable cost would be 6,667 times 5 or times mo lang isa sa 0.25. Anyway, para makita nyo, equals 6,667 times 5. That's your variable cost per unit. So 33,335. You have your contribution margin. I'll just write CM. Equals, that would be your revenue less your variable cost. So you have a contribution margin of 100,000 pesos. Okay? And your fixed cost is 100,000. So approximately supposed to be it's zero. But since may differences kita, no, sa what do you call this? Decimal point, so may 5 pesos kita nga difference. Pero supposed to be it should be zero. There is a variance lang of 5 pesos which is immaterial man. No? Kay nag ano kita nag anong tawag sini? Nag round up kita mo into whole units, but if you want to check video class, okay, para makita nyo good, okay, times 20, oh, plus 20 ni, times 20, oh, equals times 0.25, okay, oh, fixed cost mo 100,000. So muna, if you want to ano gid makita nga nag ano sa nag zero, oh, this is amo ni ha ginagamit tagid ang 6 decimal points of 0.6667 times 20 selling price, then ang aton variable cost 5, gin times ko na lang sa 0.25 since aton variable cost is 25% of our selling price. So we have a contribution margin of 100,000, we have fixed cost of 100,000, we have a profit of 0. That's break even. So correct ang aton answer nga it should we must sell 6,667 at break even, no? We're not earning profit at this point. So we'll check, no? Kung nagamit kita percentage. So if percentage ang ginagamit ta, it's ang aton answer is not in units. It's in pesos since it's percentage. So if you want to see break even sales in break even sales in pesos, so it would still be the same. That would be fixed cost divided by CM percentage. Okay, so very easy. 100,000 divided by 0.75 equals 0.75 So equals, that would be equals 100,000 divide. Okay. So correct. So it should be in pesos. Highlight ko. No? It's approximately 133,333.33 equal, or approximately 133,340. It's still the same. That's the how you get the break-even sales, no? So, arim, example siya, statement. For example, a company with 100,000 fixed cost and contribution of 40. Contribution margin of 40% must earn revenue of 250,000 to break even. So if you'll check, 100,000 divided by 40%, that would be 250,000. Okay. So contribution margin. Amuna siya ang amount nga makover, ang makover kay fixed cost. That's the contribution margin. Okay, operating leverage. So, operating leverage is a cost accounting formula that measures the degree to which a firm or project can increase operating income by increasing revenue. We will understand this more if my computation. So, a business that generates sales with a high gross margin and low variable cost has high operating leverage. So, the higher the degree of operating leverage, the greater the potential danger from forecasting risk, in which a relatively small error in forecasting sales can be magnified into large errors in cash flow production. So, we have here the formula, degree of operating leverage, also known as the DOL, is equal to CM over profit. So, where Q is your unit quantity, CM is contribution margin, that would be your selling price less variable cost per unit. Operating leverage is a measure of how much debt a company uses to finance its ongoing operation. That's operating leverage. Kung pila ang parts ng utang sa company ginagamit niya to finance its operations. That's the operating leverage. So companies with high operating leverage must cover a larger amount of fixed costs each month regardless of whether they sell any units of product. So for example here, company A sells 500,000 products for a unit price of 6. The company's fixed costs are 800,000. Its cost, variable cost is 0.05 to make each product. Okay, so calculate company A's degree of operating leverage. So you have 500 units. No? Kadto tadiwa, kagamo. Okay. So, ang bali ako, no, they are selling 500 units. Selling price is, pila tong selling price sa class? 6, and your fixed cost is 0.05. Okay. SP is 6. And your variable cost is 0.05. Okay. Okay. Yan, your fixed cost is 800,000. Am I right? To check. Yes. So, our formula for our DOL is CM over profit. Okay. CM over profit. So CM per unit. So CM per unit, it would be your selling price less your variable cost. So selling price less variable cost, it's 5.95. Okay, so to get your profit, it would be your selling price times number of quantity. So first we have to get your revenues. So it would be 500,000 units times 6, your selling price. Wala ko ka equal. Okay. So, 3 million. You have your variable cost. It's 500,000. Wala na naman ko ka-equal. Halo lang kamuklas, ha? Times 0.05. That's your variable cost. 25,000. Oh, very small. Your CM is, and you have your fixed cost. Gamma, yeah, variable cost. It's 800,000. So you have your profit. It's less 800,000. 2,175,000. Para the formula get i-red ta ang deduction. Okay, so to check 500,000 times 0.05. okay, so your profit is 2,175,000 at 500 units, selling price of 6, variable cost of 0.05. am I right? 0.05, very small. Okay, so your CM per unit is 5.95. May right? Basi balad ako dako. Ah, okay. Okay, okay, okay. So, CM 5.95 times the number of units of 500,000. So, it's 295 over your profit of 2,175. So you have a DOL of 2,175. 1.37. Double rule. Okay. Kinaklas, klaro na to, kay para makita. Good. So you have 500 units being sold. Your selling price is 6. Variable cost of 0.05, fixed cost of 800,000. You have CM per unit of 0.95. So we get here the profit, that would be your revenues less variable cost plus your contribution margin less your fixed cost. So you have a profit of 2,175,000. So to get your DOL, that would be your contribution margin of 2,975,000. No, as you could see, highlight ko sa the same color para makita. Then your 2,175 na profit. So you have a DOL of 1.37. So let's go back here. So a 10% revenue increase should result in a 13.7 increase in your operating income. So amo ni mo nga degree of operating leverage. So amo to siyang hambal ya. If you have a 10% increase on your revenue, so there will be a, if 10%, that would be 0.10. 0.10 times your degree of operating leverage of 1.37. So, would be, okay. There is an increase of 13.7% or 14. Okay. Gusto nyo ma-check, re-check ka. So, if you have an increase of 13.7% no, sa imo revenue, we'll check. So, if you have, if you will increase this by 1.137, no, kahit ay nag-increase siya by 13.7, so if you will convert this into decimal, so move ka to 2 units to the left, so 0.137. No, amo na iya increase in decimal. No, times amo na times 1.137. Ang 0.137 is the increase. Ang 1 niya is amo na 1. No, di ba amo ka na mag compute sang increase sa equals mo. It's multiply. Okay? Your a new revenue, new level of revenue would be 3,411,000. Drag ta na lang ni, masunod na sa. This would be your variable cost, may increase man by 1.37. Equals less. So your new CM is 3,382,575. Where fixed cost is still the same, no? Ay, wala mo sa Japan na change. So you have a new profit of 2,582,000. So we'll check if ang increase ni profit is also 13.7. So to get the change, it would be equals the new profit less the old profit, no? The increased profit, no? Increased profit less ang previous mga profit na wala pa increase less ang so less divided by the old the new, no? So there is a 16% increase, no? Diriya sige na lang ito di increase 12.04 CM niya is less. Check ko ha. Divided by. I know. It's new. Okay. Sala. Sorry. Sala si Miss. This would be. $3,411,000 less ang imo nga old mo nga revenue, no, previous revenue divided by the previous, no, I think we're computing the change, no, 13, so 13 man ang change ni variable cost, so your CM would also change by 13%, so fixed cost zero, so you have here. Okay. So si profit is nag-increase, no? Iya nga change. Kay nga ah, wala nag-change imo fixed cost, no? Kay kung nag-change ni imo fixed cost by 13.7%, same man iya increase. So nag-increase ang profit ya, not the same sang increase ni CM and variable cost and revenue, no? Nagtaas iya nga increase nga ah, no? Nagtaas siya by 19% ang profit mo niya. Sa imo fixed cost, wala man nag-change. No? Nagsaka imo nga profit. So, amo na sa class nga, 19% si increase ni profit. Okay, balik tadi. Operating income. So, a 10% revenue increase should result in a 13.7% increase in operating income. No, we're sala here. Ang aton nga, ang aton increase in revenue must be 0.10. Same man to bala Japan class if mag-increase ta 13.7% di, balik ta ha. Si kuno if 19% ang change, may na kay nakita ko man. Supposed to be we increase our revenue by 13.7% and our DOL is 13.7%, no? Chakto. Ano nang balya diho? Alter increase should result in 13.7. Okay. Proof ko ginaya nga 19% man Japon ang increase ni profit. If mag-increase kita 13.7 sa aton revenue. Nang balya? So, 10% increase. Tingin mo na sa Japan, eh, way, para hindi na kamo maglibog na lang ang ulo, ara na lang o 10%. Okay, ara na. Sambalya, 10% increase in profit would result to 13.7% increase in... No, 10% increase in revenue will result to 13.7% increase in profit. So, ari na siya class. No? We have an increase of 10%. Easy lang. Easy lang na pag-change. But, I'll check ha. Increase in of 13.7 will... So, 13.7.137 times 0.137. Okay, game from to be finished. Okay. Sakto man. ambal ko sa inyo ha, kagina. Diba naghambal ko nga if you have aghambal ko sa inyo kagina if I'll increase my revenue by 13%. Tama to kagina ang previous nga computation. Our profit will increase by 19%, no, as you could remember. If you still remember, 19% ko gina, no, nasala ko mo kay habi ko is 13.7% increase in revenue. It's 10%, no, kagina sa aton nga module. Pero ang ako niya na himo is nag-increase kita 13.7 revenue. So, same man Japan, no? If we have a DOL of 13.7%, we have an increase of revenue of 13.7% man. So, 0.137 increase, 0.137 man aton nga DOL, ariho. So, times, muna, times ang aton DOL. So, we have 19% increase sa aton nga profit. Same man to kagina, no? Din ano ko lang kay base mamba. Salo man to ang balimis muna. So same man to Japan, no? 0.19 man ang increase ang profit ta. Isakto man, no? Ang aton increase sa aton revenue times our DOL is equal to our increase sa aton nga profit, no? Isan i-1.2 mo pa na diho. Or 1.3 times mo bala ang increase mo day times ang imo DOL amo na ding magwa. Okay, so amo na class, hope you understand degree of operating leverage and cost volume profit analysis, the short run cost function, long run cost function and a learning curves. Thank you very much. Do madamo-damo to subong topic. Have a nice day ahead class, mag-aulan.